When your low temperature experiments are completed, you need to bring the instrument back to the ambient temperature. Very important that you should not set the VTU temperature greater than 25 degrees C when the liquid nitrogen DUR is attached. The temperature difference between incoming gas and the room temperature is very large, so the heater may be overloaded and burning out. Once the instrument is back to the room temperature, the next thing is to turn off the VTU. The gas flow in the idle state is significantly reduced, so the chilling power of the liquid nitrogen chiller becomes small. Next, we close the shim gas valve. Next step is to disconnect the nitrogen gas supply from the heat exchanger. At this point, it is safe to separate heat exchanger from the probe and reconnect BCU outlet to the probe inlet. Now we can attach nitrogen gas supply to the BCU. Now we need to set target gas flow to 200 liters per hour and target temperature to 298 Kelvin or 25 degrees C for the next user. We'll grab gas supply to the heat exchanger and detach it from separate. Our next step is to detach heat exchanger from the probe. We are going to undo the Velcro strap first, then rotate the foam pad down. Then I can unscrew the nut until I feel it completely free and pull the heat exchanger in and then go out. Our next step, they're using gloves to remove the cold heat exchanger from the DUR. Very cold, and we want to use gloves for this. On the foam pad, we're going to place it over here and cover it to prevent frostbite and all the red pipe goes on top. Put in the cap, carefully pull it out. Finally, all the ends of heat exchanger, needs to be protected by this part, which will be metal going in, and then I screw it in, and this protects the Johnson coupler. So I can now put it back. My next step is to reattach BCU back to the probe. I'm going to grab this pipe and put it over here. Now I'm going to align it, push it in, and then screw in this retaining nut. The last part is to readjust the Velcro such that it holds the pipe in place. We're going to need its end, and it will go straight into here, and you just push and then you pull to check that it is right in place. Final step is to close the shin guard valve. All you need to do is just to fully close, rotating it clockwise. Closed.